Well, in the case of Drive, a video which you mentioned was directed by the actor, Timothy Hutton, mm-hmm. there is a woman who gives a superior performance of someone who is very emotionally disturbed. How did you find this unknown face?
I think it was a friend of Tim's. I'm sure Rick knows more about that aspect than I do, but it was a friend, as far as I know, it was a friend of Tim's, and he just worked mainly with the three of us for hours, told us what he'd like to have us do, and the way we should, you know, we should feel the general concept of the song to him.
It's been real easy.
I think it made us respect each other's talents more and brought us closer, didn't
you? Sure. It's just a nice romantic album. We tried to put a lot of people's thoughts and feelings in there as best we could. I have, you know, 5 or 6 phone calls a day, you know, cars breaking up. No, we're not breaking up. There's no reason to break up. It's a business, and it's a pleasure. And we're going to just continue on.
Benjamin Orr has recently joined fellow car Rick Ocasek on the playlists of radio stations around the globe. That means more good music for Cars fans. Ben says he likes doing solo work, but there's one key difference from his work with the Cars.
I had a lot more to do, basically. It was like constant, you know, 13-hour shifts in the studio. Where more or less the other Cars albums, I'd be there for 3 or 4 hours a day.
It, but Ben sings lead on almost half the car songs. I don't mind
coming here. Well, we started out with Just What I Needed. That was the first one that I did, and then Moving in Stereo and All Mixed Up. Let's Go after that. And various others.
Notable among those various others is Drive. Benjamin Orr singing Drive and playing with pal Rick Ocasek, who he met while he was still living in Ohio.
Got a phone call one afternoon. He said he'd like to meet me because he was watching me do this number on this television show called Upbeat. And became friends after that and pretty much stuck together.
Singing for you tonight, Mark Goodman here and my guest Benjamin Orr. Welcome, Ben.
Hi, Mark.
Great to have you here. After all this time, I've been waiting for this solo record for a long time. In fact, why don't I give America a look at this? It's called The Lace. Everybody's been seeing the video on MTV. And when did we do that private affair with the Cars? Like 2 years ago?
Yeah.
And you and I were talking then about this record. And I thought I remembered you saying to me, yeah, I got all the songs, I'm ready to go. What happened?
Just slow, Mark. That's all there is to it, and just slow.
But no, there's what has happened over these 2 years? Did you go and record a whole different album that you threw away because you hated, or is this what you had when we talked 2 years ago?
No, it happened when they sent me off the contract to do this thing. I was in the middle of rebuilding my house, so I had to finish that first because I couldn't stand walking in there again, just tripping over things. So I took a year doing that, and then we did pre-production on this. That took about 3.5 months. And then forever in Beckington, England. Thank you very much. It was great fun, though.
Now, you have a co-writer on this record.
Yeah.
On all the songs.
Diane Gray Page, I assume you're talking about?
That's exactly who I'm talking about.
That girl, yeah.
And that's her on the back, I'm guessing, huh?
That's it.
Who is she? How did one come to know? How'd you come to know her, and where does she fit in your life? Is she in the kitchen, or what?
This is my woman here, and we've been together for about 3 years. We're having a lot of fun. We didn't know this would happen, but she was very talented, so I ended up with some great lyrics.
How did it happen that you started to write together? That's got to be a pretty big move to actually sit down and start to bare your soul with someone, huh?
Yeah, I had the tunes pretty much laid out, but my weakest point are lyrics, so I needed some help on lyrics.
Uh-huh.
And I asked her if she wanted to try a few with me, and the first one got into the second one. And
what was the first one, just for laughs?
Stay the Night.
Stay the Night was the first one?
Yeah, yeah.
We were talking about the record taking so darn long, but there's other things that have been involved. Now, you mentioned the production over in England. I was surprised that you even recorded the record over there. Why did you decide to bother with England? You got your own studio in Boston.
It's probably cheaper. Me, Mark. I don't know, actually.
You don't know?
They pretty much wanted me to go over there. I don't know why. I fought against it for a while.
Uh-huh.
I actually wanted to do it in Boston. but it didn't work out. I guess the dollar stretches a little farther in England.
Uh-huh. And you wound up doing your first ever video on your own.
Yeah.
Was that an uncomfortable situation for you?
That was great. Actually, I had a large part in the video, producing the video, from, you know, editing sessions down to beat patterns on dissolves. It was great fun. It was something new. I guess not too many bands are involved with their own videos.
It's something, for some reason, I would expect you to be into it for some reason. The Cars, of course, were so into video, and video is such a big part of what they are about these days.
Mm. Yeah, I enjoyed it. I want to do it again, if I can.
So did you get a directing credit on this video?
No, actually.
Are you going to go for a directing credit on the next one?
Not really. I mean, my name's all over the place anyway. I'm getting tired of seeing it. But no, it was a great experience, and I had great help. The crews were great. They listened to the things I had to say.
Do you consider yourself to be a prolific songwriter? In other words, do you think you make a lot of songs so that now, sure, you got a whole album of great songs here, but maybe there's still going to be a couple of things that you want to contribute to the Cars, or now it's like you have nothing in mind for the Cars, you're just going to go in and let Rick carry the football?
Yeah, it's never come up in conversation. Just play it by ear for now.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe we'll do a couple songs in concert. Maybe not.
Especially now that so many members have done solo work. Yeah. That might be fun, wouldn't it?
Yeah, I hope stretch the show a bit.
Yeah.
Another 10 minutes here, you know.
I got to ask you about a tour. Are you going to have the time? Do you want to?
For the solo album?
Yeah.
Not enough time this year. Maybe with the first album, it's kind of difficult. I'd probably do 4 or 5 off of this and then a lot of Cars' greatest hits. But we'll wait for the second album, I think. Cars are supposed to start a new album in February, and we'll be out on tour next year anyhow.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe with the second album, we'll try it.
But you do want to do it. That's good.
Oh, yeah, definitely. I don't get to play enough.
Uh-huh.
It'd be nice to be out there on the road again.
Just, I know this is intense speculation, especially because you're not even thinking about a tour until after the second record. Would you put Elliot Easton, who plays on this record,
yeah,
would he be in the road band if you went out?
I haven't thought about it, but it's always good to see the guys drop in whenever,
yeah,
they want to. They're welcome.
Well, the record is called The Lace. Benjamin, Don't Call Me Ben, or... And a wonderful new record. Congratulations on it. I know you're going to have good luck, and thanks for coming by tonight.
Thank you very much.
With us on Line 1, Ben Orr, and listening to us on station WZWZ in Kokomo, Indiana, is Andy. We'd like to talk to Andy. Are you there?
Yes.
How good?
Good.
And Ben is here. Would you like to ask a question?
Yes, I want to know, do you plan to stay with the Cars? And if so, do you plan to release any more solo albums?
Yeah, I have every intention of staying with the Cars, and we're going to do more single albums, I guess, as soon as we can get around to it. The Cars are supposed to start a new album in February, and we'll be on a world tour next year.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Thanks a lot, Andy and Kokomo. And also with us, a question tonight from Detroit, Michigan, Danny, listening to WLLZ Wheels.
Hi.
Hi, Danny.
Hi. Okay, I got a question for you, Ben. I'm just wondering, did you always know that you wanted to be in the music business? And if you didn't, when did you seriously start to think about it?
I started taking lessons actually when I was about 8 years old, and my parents told me I ruined a whole lot of their stuff at home, just, you know, pounding around on tables. So I always knew that I wanted to do some sort of music. They gave me the opportunity to pursue it to its maximum, I guess. Okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Thanks, Danny. And listening to us on station WLVQ in Columbus, Ohio, is Robert. Robert, you got a question for our friend Ben Orr?
I was wondering, how much exactly did you do in the making of your new video, and did you enjoy it?
Yeah, this time I really enjoyed it. I not only got to act in it and watch what was going on, but I also was a part of the production, along with editing and color schemes, the whole routine that you do with a video, I guess.
That sounds like fun. Keep it up.
It was great fun this time around, I have to say.
Well, keep up the good work.
Thank you, sir.
Bye.
Okay. All right, thank you, Columbus, Ohio. And another call now from Philadelphia, from WMMR listening area. John?
Yeah?
Hi there.
Hi, how you doing?
Got a question for Benjamin Orr.
Yes, I do. Ben reminds me of this actor, Rutger Hauer, a very fine actor.
Yeah.
And I believe that Ben has some acting capabilities, as he shows in his videos. And I was wondering, as he just mentioned to the last caller, that he likes acting in his videos, if he would pursue an acting career on full-length films if he was offered a good script.
Yeah, I probably would. Just for the fun of it, sure, I would.
Okay.
Are you recommending that? Are you urging that along?
Well, I'm urging. I was wondering if he would, you know, if someone, a good agent or someone out there saw Ben's videos or just, you know, mainly looked at him in the other car videos or what have you and figured, hey, I'd like to see this guy act in films like, per se, David Bowie does in his, you know, he does his singing career, but he also has an acting career. He's a very fine actor.
Mm-hmm.
I was just wondering if Ben would pursue an acting career.
Well, I understand that they, some people from Miami Vice actually asked me to do a portion of one of their shows, but we were doing Live 8 at the time, so that pretty much fell through, and I haven't heard anything since.
Okay, but if it was in the back shelf, I mean, you know, they came up again, Miami Vice asked you to do it again, you would, wouldn't you?
Yeah, sure, I would.
Okay.
Wouldn't you?
We're live in Boston, and right now we're going to go to Los Angeles to radio station KMET, K-M-E-T, and Brad, are you there?
Hello.
Hi, Brad.
How are you doing, Ben?
Just fine, thank you.
Good, good to talk to you. Hey, I noticed a lot of people are doing interviews with you nowadays, and beforehand, at least with the cars, Rick Ocasek did a lot of that. How do you like doing the interviews and being up front about the cars and yourself and your band?
It's nice to be able to do this portion of it. I didn't mind the other portion, actually. It was okay. It was a lot easier, actually, than it is now.
Really? Okay, well, it's good to talk to you, and more power to you. I really love the group, and you're doing great. Thanks a lot for talking.
Thank you, Paul.
Bye-bye.
That's Brad in Los Angeles, and now we go to Paul in New York, who's listening on WNEW-FM. Paul?
Ben, hi. Love your music. In a recent interview, you said that Stay the Night wasn't your favorite song on the album. I was wondering if you could tell us which is your favorite song and why.
Well, the reason why it's not, I can't say it's not my favorite song. It's just a song, the first song we ever wrote together, Diane and myself. And, you know, it's like the one I've been most familiar with. I've been living with it for about 3 years. And I like up-tempo songs, so, you know, probably my first choice would be like In Circles or Hot to Stop or something like that.
We might just do that later.
Okay.
All right, well, the entire album is great.
Thank you very much.
Okay.
Bye. Thank you, Paul. Let's go now to station KKCK, Marshall, Minnesota. And on the line in Minnesota is Tom.
Hi, Ben. My question is, now that you and Rick Ocasek have both, you know, ventured out into the solo stuff, how is this going to affect your relationship with Rick?
Oh, we're still great friends. There's no problem here, as far as I know.
Is this going to affect your role? As maybe more, you're going to get more singing songs on the future Cars albums, or?
Well, on all the Cars albums, it pretty much broke down to me doing about half or maybe a song less on any of the Cars songs that we've done.
Okay. Well,
so
great.
I imagine.
Thank you.
You're welcome, bye.
Getting back to Ben Orr now, I've got a quick question I'd like to ask you. You know, I heard that Stay the Night was the first song you ever wrote, but you must have been involved with some aspect of songwriting with the Cars. So what things did you apply to your own songwriting method that you learned from just being around Rick Ocasek and the rest of the band?
Well, first of all, I never really got around to doing any songwriting in the Cars. My part was pretty much bass and doing a little bit of chorus background, you know. This whole songwriting thing started with The Lace, and that's where it's at.
All right, Benjamin Orr, our guest. Yeah. We're live in Boston on line one. Good answer. More to come, right? More live stuff? I mean, you're going to write your own songs some more. Are you doing that now?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, I was doing that about an hour before I got back from this studio.
Great, so we have more songs by Ben Orr to look forward to. And we've got some phone calls to look forward to right now, too. And we'll be listening now to Alexandria, Louisiana. KQID, Chuck is on the line for Ben.
Hello, Ben. So how's the weather in Boston?
Oh, lovely.
Okay, I've been waiting quite a long time for your solo album since Rick Ocasek, Kelly Deason, and Greg Hawkins all have solo albums. I was wondering why it took you so long to put one out on the market.
I was tied up with other personal things, you know, around the house. I just took my time. I wanted to do it right. You know, it's a pretty scary thing to do it for the first time, and you want to make sure everything falls into place. So it took a little extra time this time.
I can see that. I got one more question for you. What is your favorite Cars album?
I probably would go with Heartbeat City, since it's the newest and I'm the least tired of it.
I know what you mean. Thanks a lot for your time, man. It's really nice to talk to you.
You bet. Thank you.
Okay, Chuck in Alexandria, Louisiana. Listening right now in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania on WMMR is Rick. Are you there, Rick?
Yeah, I'm there.
You
hi,
have a
Ben.
Question for Ben?
Yeah, hi, Ben.
Hi.
Yes. I'd like to know, what is your favorite personal Cars song or songs?
Well, I'm pretty partial to Drive, actually. But, my favorite? Probably When You're Gone.
Okay, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
And on the telephone in Iron Mountain, Michigan, listening to us tonight on WJNR is Terry. A question for you, Mr. Orr. Terry?
Yeah, Ben.
Hi.
I heard you wrote most of your songs around Boston. And could you tell me why it was a good place to write and why you chose to live there?
Well, most of the music we did in a small studio that I have set up in my home. But for the lyrics, I made up cassettes, took my truck and or car down to the ocean on one of the piers down here in Boston Harbor, and we wrote the lyrics from inside those.
Was there, you wanted to sort of know what he was doing in Boston instead of where, instead of Ohio?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, Ben?
Well, I live here. That's a good start. I moved to Boston here about 13 years ago, and I've just lived here ever since.
Oh. Okay, well, that just answers my questions.
Thanks, Terry.
Yep.
By the way, if you want to call us, the number is 1-800-ROCKERS, 1-800-ROCKERS. And from Portsmouth, New Hampshire now, listening on WHEB is Renee Norton. Renee?
Hi, Ben. Hi. I'd like to ask this. You sang lead on Cars hits before. So why do you think the song Dry brought you so much attention as a vocalist?
Well, it was a great song. Rick wrote a fabulous song, though.
I agree.
And I got lucky and was able to sing it. And probably Live Aid helped a whole lot on from the British side and from the American side.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Renee. And let's go to Columbus, Ohio on the telephone now. Laura, who's listening to WLVQ in Columbus.
Hi, Ben.
Hi.
How did you feel when Elektra Records approached you about doing a solo record?
I got pretty nervous there for a while. Because I had never done anything like this before, so I wanted to do a good job. And when they asked me to do it, I said, sure, I'd do it. But then shortly thereafterward, I got a little nervous.
Okay, thank you.
Just a normal thing, you know.
Thanks, Laura in Ohio. And we're going to take another caller now. Listening on WCCC in Hartford, Connecticut, Kristen. Kristen, got a question for Ben?
What?
Do you have a question for Ben?
Yep.
Okay, go to it.
Hi, I really like the Cars and was wondering, what do the members of the Cars think of your solo album?
We pretty much support each other, whatever project that we do. I imagine that they're pretty happy. I hope they would be. I was counting on them. Okay.
Yep. Bye.
Bye. On line one in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, Randy, who's listening to WHTF. Randy, question for Ben Orr.
Yes, Ben, I just listened to the album just yesterday. It's fantastic. Loved it.
Thank you very much.
You're
welcome. It's nice to hear. I really like that.
Okay, what was the first car song you heard on the radio?
First car song?
Yeah.
It was Just What I Needed. The local station here in Boston, WBCN, was the first to play it, and they played rough cuts before the even album was mixed or released or anything like that.
How did you feel about hearing it?
I'm sorry?
How did you feel about hearing it?
Oh, it was a good feeling. First time out, yeah.
Really? Hey,
great.
Keep rocking.
Okay.
Thanks very much, Randy. We're going to go to Clearfield, Pennsylvania, listening on WQYX. I think that's Shirley?
Cheryl.
Okay, good, Cheryl. You got a question, please?
Yes. Hi, Ben.
Hi.
I was wondering, do you think it's possible that you can reach the high goals as the Cars?
Guess he already did, really. He is a car.
Yeah, well.
A streamlined blonde car. No, he's a car right now, too, you know.
Uh-huh.
He's achieved that. Now he's going to just do some solo stuff, right?
Yeah, we'll try that. I don't know exactly what you meant.
Well, I meant, do you think you can become as successful as the Cars? Like, you know?
Oh, myself, personally, on my own career, this solo thing?
Right.
Well, we'll give it a good try, won't we?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, thank you.
Thanks, Cheryl, very much. And in Boston, in our area where we are right now, WAAF, and listening on AAF is Nick. Hello,
hi.
Nick.
Hi, Nick.
How are you?
Okay, real good.
I have a question for you. I have a controversy with my friends. In the song, When You're Gone, what are you writing about?
That's Rick's job. I don't know what comes from Rick's mind for when he writes his lyrics. That's pretty much left up to Rick. You'd have to ask him about that one.
Oh, sorry about that. I thought it was yours.
No, I don't write any of the songs in the Cars.
The songs that are on this album, he has written. Actually, this is your first songwriting. You've sung on a lot of the songs.
That's right.
I think is what he means. And Diane Gray Page is with us also as a co-writer on many of the songs with Benjamin Orr. So, just in case you wanted to know that. All right. Anything else, Nick?
On the album, on he has a song on his album titled "When You're Gone."
On my album?
Yes.
Oh, okay. We're talking about my album.
Your album, yes.
Okay, I made a mistake earlier because I said one of my favorite car songs was When You're Gone, and it's not When You're Gone, it's Since You're Gone. Okay, mm-hmm. Now I know what you're talking about. Now, what was your question?
What is the meaning in that song? What are you writing about?
It's pretty much the feeling that when your friend isn't there anymore, you sort of miss them a lot, whoever it may be, male or female.
Mm.
Has that meaning to it.
Okay, thanks a lot.
You bet.
All right, thank you, Nick.
Understanding.
Portsmouth, New Hampshire area. It's probably colder there in Boston for sure. WHEB, the station, and Michelle is on the line for you, Ben Orr.
Hi, Ben.
Hello. Hi.
What was your most memorable experience with the Cars?
Oh, probably Live Aid, I would say. We had a really nice time there, and it was great playing for the world.
Michelle, did you say, what was the name of the group again?
The Cars?
That's
all right, I've got a Portsmouth accent.
That's kind of a Boston accent, too. We were just having some fun about that. Do they do that in Portsmouth also, pack the car?
All the time. I'm really from Rochester, but we called in.
Okay.
Not going to come back with the accent?
No. You do a real good job of that, Michelle.
Gee, thanks.
Is it cold there? What's the temperature in Portsmouth?
Oh, I'd say about 30 or so.
Well, it's not that much colder than it is here.
Really, I'm going to do the weather for Portsmouth in about 2 minutes.
All right.
So hang in there, and you'll hear a great weather report.
All right.
Thank you. And we have someone else who had a question for Benjamin.
I have a question.
Where are you? No, where's the person? Is this you? No, right here. Oh, your name is?
Greg McGuire.
Greg, what question did you have for Ben?
I'd like to know how come David Robinson wasn't on any of the solo albums from The Cars?
I don't know, actually. David did the graphic design on my album. That's about all I could get time enough from him for, I guess. But he's still wanting to play, I guess. We'll be playing next year. Hang in there.
Yep.
Good question, Greg.
Okay. Ken, you there?
Yeah, I'm there, Scott. We have a young lady who would like to ask Benjamin something about his, I think, his performance in his acting career.
Yeah.
How you doing? I had heard a while ago that you were going to be doing a Miami Vice. Whatever happened with that?
I was just told about it. No one actually approached me on it. They just said to somebody else, and I don't know who it was, that I was supposed to try to do one, but no one ever got back to me, so I never did it. But did you didn't hear it from me.
What do you think of the party?
It's a great party, isn't it? A lot of videos, a lot of beautiful people. Having a good time.
How's the tour going up there?
Real well, actually.
Doing anything special now that you're working on, or just playing along?
Just going along with the flow, actually.
Any special plans coming up?
No, just trying to stay healthy. Getting over the flu right now.
Where are you going from here?
Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, I believe.
How about getting back to the studio?
Probably do some studio work when we finish the tour in later September. I have a solo album to do, so I'm working on that now.
What's your favorite city along the tour to play in?
Oh, gosh. I like them all, actually. How's that?
Okay, but...
Well, there's always New York, Los Angeles, my hometown.
You from L.A.?
No, I was actually born in Cleveland, Ohio.
How long are you with the group now?
I've been with the group since the inception, about 6 years ago, 77.
Do you have any plans down the line at all for doing work on your own, or what's
that? Yeah, well, I have a solo album that I'm going to be doing starting probably in November. I hope for a springtime release.
Any tapes involved in that?
Any what?
Any tape, videotape?
Well, if the album sells fairly well, I hope they'll do a videotape somewhere along the line. That'd be nice.
Anything you'd like to add that I haven't thought about?
Just great to be here, and I hope everybody keeps doing what they're doing. Whatever they mean. What's that?
Meadowlands went well tonight.
Yeah, it seemed to go well.
What's your feeling about playing like a place like the Meadowlands,
where
how many seats
do you sell? I've heard 20,000 to 30,000. I'm not quite sure. I don't really know.
How's that compared with, let's say, Forest Hills?
It all depends on the audience, I think. If you got a good audience and they're really into it, it doesn't really matter where you play. Just so they're having a good time. That's really what it's all about. Yeah. No, none that I know of.
Pops up in spins all the time. You know, things you don't hear about just pop up.
As far away as Boston, Benny Orr of the Cars, who grew up here in Cleveland, came home to join the cause.
Kid Leo called me up. We were here in the studio. I'm working on my album right now. And he called me up and said, we're doing this thing for CARE. And he said, would you mind coming down and singing some vocal tracks on it? I said, no, I didn't mind at all.
Ben Orr is here with us from the Cars.
Hi, how are you?
How about this?
It's great. It's just awesome.
Whoa, can you believe it? A Led Zeppelin reunion?
Unbelievable. It wouldn't happen again, and I couldn't even imagine. I couldn't imagine it happening again.
Ben was rocking.
Ben, all together, how would you rate today's event as a rock and roll concert?
I'll give it a 3. No, this is great. It's wonderful. Just so much. Wall of people. It's wonderful.
What were you guys doing that you had to cancel? I know you had to cancel some gigs to be here tonight.
Yeah, they told me I was supposed to do some kind of thing. It's a TV thing, but I don't know about it. It's just rumor.
It's
supposed to be like a Miami Vice thing, but I don't know. I think it was a rumor myself.
Something sort of like a Miami Vice thing.
I think it was supposed to be a Miami Vice thing. I didn't get a chance to talk to Don, but he's around here somewhere. I might run into him later.
And I know
this is great.
You stuck around and been watching the show. What's been the most thrilling moment for you as a fan?
as a fan, I just met Ron Lane backstage. I didn't get to see him when we were there in England 2 years ago. So I was talking to him back there, and that was just terrific. He's sitting there by himself.
Ronnie Lane.
He's coming out here probably soon. Someone's going to find him.
Beat City, an album the Cars chose not to record in America.
The reason that we did go to England was to get away from the distractions in Boston, our hometown, and just for an environmental change and for inspiration and all those things combined.
Ben Orr. Rick and I have always gotten along, especially musically. We're good friends as well, but probably the reason why we kept playing together so long is strictly because of the music. Not strictly because of the music, just because the music and the friendship were wonderful through all these years, and it's continuing on.
Ben, I just want to know that I really admire your voice and think you can sing very well. But my question to you is, have you ever considered going into acting, and if so, what kind of roles would you like to take part in?
I considered it, and nothing's come my way.
I have a question for Ben. Ben, I, as a fellow bass player, I was wondering, you've definitely inspired my playing. Who inspired you over the past, as far as your playing and everything?
Gosh, all the great bass players have played all the great songs that were ever written.
We're going to talk now to Brian, who's in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, listening to 97 GTR, and Brian's on the show with Ben and Rick.
Hey, Ben.
Brian.
How you doing?
Okay.
I just want to plug this, like, you're my idol here. You're singing, and I loved your solo album.
Brian.
And along those lines, I was wondering, who, like, decides the lead vocals of the group? Because I know you sing on a lot of the songs. I don't know if everyone realizes that.
Yeah, that comes up pretty much at the time we first hear the songs. You know, Rick sometimes has a certain person in mind to do the song, and it's the way he constructs the song. So once we hear the songs for the first time, then we chat about, you know, who we think would do the best job, and we pick it from there.
Back to the phones, we go to Durham, Connecticut this time. We're going to talk to Terry, and she is listening to 106 HCN in Hartford. Terry, you're on with the Cars.
Hi, guys. How you doing?
Fine.
This one is for Ben.
Okay.
I would like to know if you have started or am going to start on another solo album, and if so, when will that be out?
Well, I've already started writing some material for it, but it probably won't be out for a while because this tour is going to take quite a bit of time. Probably somewhere after next fall.
Hi, this is Benjamin Orr of the Cars.
Formed in Boston in early 1977. The founding members were lead singer, songwriter, and rhythm guitar player Rick Ocasek and his friend, bass player and vocalist Benjamin Orr.
Rick and I have been playing together for about 8 years together. At the time when we first came to Boston, we found Greg Hawks, our keyboard player, and he did some tracks with us at the local studio, and we loved him. He was great, he was incredible. Words can't describe it. For myself, anyhow. So we kept him, and he was around. He played with a couple other bands in the meantime, but we always did studio stuff together. Then we found Elliot. He joined Rick and myself for a while, and then Rick and Elliot and Greg, and then came David. We stole him from DMZ at the time, and that's how we formed, actually. We started practicing in Rick's cella, and the band got together. We went out to the studio. We decided to do some live two-track tapes, but they were. We laid them down in the studio. After a few months, one of the disc jockeys in Boston picked it up. They just started playing it, and the people started calling in with response. The next thing I knew, it was being played every day, you know, 2-3 times a day, just a live two-track tape. That word got to New York. New York loved it. Out came the record companies in droves. Saw us and, started making offers.
The Cars signed with Elektra Records and connected with English record producer Roy Thomas Baker.
Roy happened to come on the scene while we were playing a gig at Harvard University. in Boston. And he came, he liked it. We talked. He said, will you? He says, okay. He's a professional to begin with, and he doesn't have to rely on one specific sound, as we do.
The band recorded their debut album, The Cars, in London in February of 1978. The LP yielded their first hit single, Just What I Needed. In late 1978, the band toured the United States, France, Holland, Belgium, and Germany. And as Benjamin Orr recalls, they were unsure how foreign audiences would receive them, as was the case when they played in London.
We were told that the British audiences were very subdued. They would definitely scope you out, make sure that you knew that they were there. Fortunately, they were absolutely incredible while we were here. Beautiful people.
And Benjamin Orr.
Whether you want to or not, you have to know about the business as much as you can. Otherwise, you're going to walk in the studio blind, or you're going to sign a piece of paper, and then God knows what's going to happen to you then. There's so many bands out there that are just wandering around doing whatever they do and not making any money at it because they didn't know in the first place that they can ask for certain things and really get it.
The unique rhythm sounds of the Cars are supplied by drummer David Robinson and bass player Benjamin Orr.
For me, it's power. Myself and David supply the power. We are the engine. That's what it is to me. It's also melodic. A bass instrument is melodic to me. I don't go into playing straight boom, boom, four, you know. I like to experiment a bit and sweeten it up, put a little melody behind the bass part. I think it helps. We'll let the audience be the judge.
You made a lot of videos.
Yeah.
What's the best thing about making a video?
I think the best thing about making a video is waiting. I enjoy waiting a lot. Just stand here in hallways and wait.
And what's the worst thing?
Probably waiting.
Ben, did you think of yourself as the sexy one?
Well, hell no. Randy maybe, but not the sexy one.
The amazing Randy.
Sven Harlander, there you go. No. I've always kept my one foot on the ground. It's just a show, act. And then you leave the stage and you're somebody else. But nobody else sees that, except these guys and the crew.
It's a long road from the local club skit to a national tour, but according to the Cars bass player, Ben Orr, it's still the audience that keeps you going.
I like the road a lot. It's nice to go out once every couple of years and shake off the dust, as it were. It's nice. Performing on a stage makes the day worthwhile, actually. Because you have an outlet. At least it is for me. A lot of young guys want to go out on the road and see what it's like, so we got a chance. In great detail, the first few years.
According to Cars bass player Ben Orr, it all happened so fast, the band really didn't have time to wonder why.
The Cars just sort of happened without anybody really realizing it. I didn't really realize it. You know, being through a number of bands like I was, you know, it seemed like the next best shot. So we had a try, and it just happened real fast. I didn't really have time to think about it.
And for bass player Ben Orr, rockabilly was an early major influence.
I think I was born a musician, actually. I didn't really have that much choice, you know. Had no interest in anything at all. I didn't really like school that much. But, you know, like I grew up on the early radio stuff with Buddy Holly and Big Bopper and Carl Perkins and Elvis and even a little Johnny Cash thrown in there. A whole lot of rockabilly. I started out playing actually rockabilly.
For any band to stay together for a number of years requires not only playing well together, but getting along well together. According to Cars bass player Ben Orr, cooperation is a key.
I mean, if you're playing in a band with someone, you have to respect them for what they do and you can't fight them at every corner. We get along pretty well, I would imagine, because we each respect each other's own background and their abilities. And, you know, if there's a problem, you have to file it under the right perspective, you know. You can't let it blow out of shape. If you have a problem, let's take care of it, but let's do it,
you know, so the band stays together, because why not? Why shouldn't the band stay together? And it's working well for us, so why cut your own throat? I mean, an ego is an ego, you know, and you can fortify your ego within a group if you really want to.
Bassist Ben Orr. I've changed instruments according to how much I wanted to keep playing. Some bands in town didn't need a drummer, so I started playing rhythm. And some didn't need a rhythm, so I started playing bass. Some didn't need any of those, so I started playing with keyboards, which I'm not very good at, but I fake it.
David Robinson and Ben Orr.
It had more of a Latin beat to it in the beginning. The very beginning of Drive, yeah. We changed that around, straightened it out a bit.